I am hardly a grill master, but this easy summertime meal of grilled steak and vegetables, I've got this down to a science. The secret? Flavor the butter, not the steak. I'll start with maybe half a stick of softened butter. You can speed soften butter by putting it in the microwave on low power. Nuke it for 10 seconds, give it a quarter turn. Another 10 seconds, another quarter turn. You do that 3 or 4 times and it'll be nice and soft, but not melted. Now, I'll chop up a few cloves of garlic. Also chop up a bunch of parsley or whatever herbs you want. The trick to easily chopping herbs is to bunch them up on themselves. Then you can just mow through them. Garlic and parsley go into the butter along with a ton of pepper and stir it all up. That's way more solid ingredients than people normally put in a compound butter. If you want more butter, go for it, but I'm mostly in this for the garlic. Now, that'll get better as it just sits around for a while, which is why I do it first. If you put it in the fridge, though, don't forget you'll need to soften it up again before you grill. Successful grilling is all about planning and having everything that you need right at hand, ready to go. Here is the undisputed champion of charcoal lighters, the chimney starter. Nothing else comes close. I use natural lump charcoal. It burns far hotter than reconstituted briquettes, and the flavor it gives is amazing. Fill it up most of the way. Then you need some kindling to get it going. Many things could work, but this never fails me. I take a cardboard paper towel tube, cut it in half, and then jam a paper towel inside each one. Put those on the lower grill grate and light them up. Nice, dry, thin material with plenty of air flowing around it. Perfect kindling. Make sure they're really burning before you layer the chimney starter on top. Give that 10 minutes and it will be a glowing tower of fiery doom. Back inside now for our last minute prep. Zucchini is a perfect grilling vegetable. Shout out if you call it a courgette. There is a secret special way to cut it though. Get rid of the ends, cut it in half lengthwise, then into quarters. Then stand the quarter up on its side and cut off the triangular point. That's where the seeds are, and that's the part that always goes slimy when cooked. I just toss it. What we have left is a solid piece with uniform thickness that'll have a firm, crunchy texture when cooked, and that will lie flat on the grill grates. When I started doing this, it gave me a whole new appreciation for zucchini. I never liked that slimy core. One zucchini per person is probably fine. I'm going with two because I love vegetables and these are so easy and so good. All right, I put them into a big plastic bin, light and easy to carry out to the grill. Now, steaks for about 4 people. Couple of nice ribeyes, an inch thick at most. I think both very thick and very thin steaks are much more challenging to grill. Speaking of thick, here's one of those absurdly thick pieces of tenderloin that butchers always cut. You gotta be really good at temperature control to successfully grill a steak that thick, so I just cut it in half. There you go, 2 1-inch thick fillets. Lauren will want one of those. All steaks in the bin. Here's a metal baking tray where I will put all of my finished food. I'm gonna take a spoonful of my garlic butter and smear it onto the side where I will lay the freshly grilled steaks. That will flavor their undersides and their residual heat will take the edge off of the garlic. Now, just a splash of oil goes on the zucchini. Looks like a lot, but that's a lot of zucchini. Lots of pepper, lots of salt. You could do lots of other seasonings too. I like a splash of some vinegar. I'll just toss that around and get everything coated. Everything must be ready to drop onto the grill before it goes out that back door. Otherwise, you're gonna have a bad time. To that end, just the tiniest bit of oil goes on the steaks, just enough for a super light coating all around. I'll show you later what too much oil would do. Enough salt and pepper to cover all the steaks. If you were definitely gonna use my board sauce method, there wouldn't be much purpose in seasoning these now, but seasoning immediately before cooking does give you the option of serving the steaks whole with a nice crust. Just toss those around in the seasoning, everything goes outside, and uh-oh! Shooting the video slowed down my prep, and my charcoal burned down a lot. Guess I was inside for about 25 minutes. I'm gonna layer on a bunch of fresh charcoal to compensate. I would normally layer on about half this many fresh chunks at this stage. No problem, they'll still light right up. Grill grate goes on, and yeah, that's pretty yucky from my previous grill session. No problem, you just let it heat for a couple of minutes, and then you can scrape it clean with a wire brush. Comes right off. And you want to give that grate a couple of minutes to get hot anyway, otherwise the steaks are more likely to stick to them. Hey, real quick, this recipe is sponsored by Audible. If you're an Amazon Prime member like me, you've got a limited time in which you can sign up for an Audible membership and get 66% off your first 3 months. That's 30 bucks off. That's like getting 3 months for the price of one. Get that membership and you can listen to the amazing new audio cookbook, Our Harlem by Marcus Samuelson. This is an Audible Originals production that a colleague of mine from my radio days helped make. Hi, Martha. The book explores the cultural heritage of this iconic New York neighborhood through its food. Each chapter is a day of the week in which Samuelson explores themes like the Great Migration, Spanish Harlem, all in conversation with Harlem personalities like Bevy Smith, Dapper Dan, and Jelani Cobb.
Yet, this is the most iconic dish in the African-American community. You can have all the dishes you want on the menu, but if you don't have a good fried chicken, you might as well not open the restaurant.
Seriously, it's so good, and you can only hear it on Audible. To get that big discount, go to audible.com/AdamRagusia or text AdamRagusia to 500-500. You'll pay just $4.95 per month for your first 3 months, and after that, it's just $14.95 per month. That offer is only good during this month, July. Link is in the description. Thank you, Audible. Now let's grill. Okay, the ribeyes are bigger, they'll take longer, so they go on first. If you don't hear sizzle, your grill's not hot enough yet. Now, see that flame licking that one steak a little bit? You want to avoid that. Direct flame char on meat tastes burned, and more significantly, it can be carcinogenic. One solution is to use your tongs to rotate the grill grate to get the meat away from the flame. After 2 or 3 minutes, they're looking ready to flip. Under ideal circumstances, they won't stick when you're ready to flip, but if they do seem like they might, you can take a metal spatula and just scrape it underneath to release. Then they'll flip right over and you won't lose any precious crust bits that would have stuck to the bars. Now, you might like a darker crust on yours. For what it's worth, when I grill my steaks as dark as I would get them in the pan, they tend to taste a little burned to me. I have learned through experience to be more conservative with the color when I grill. Oh, by the way, for safety purposes, after you've flipped the still raw meat, just hold your tongs down into the fire for a second. That'll definitely kill any germs on there. Now, this is where it really pays to have practiced cooking steak enough that you can judge doneness by feel. A lot of the visual cues that I would normally look for when cooking inside just don't look the same out here on the grill, and because the temperatures are so extreme, I find it really hard to get an accurate thermometer reading. So I'm just poking. Medium rare is soft, but it bounces back at you. Rare is squishy. It's been 3 minutes since I flipped them. They're almost done, so it's time for the garlic butter. Smear a big spoonful onto each one. Now, if we had put that garlic directly on the steak, it would have burned black by now. The butter is a really effective, convenient way of delivering a ton of flavor right at the end, so it only gets the minute of cooking that it needs. Now check this out. See those crazy flame-ups I'm getting? That's what would have been happening this whole entire time if we had put too much oil on the steaks. Fat is fuel. It's biodiesel. It bursts right into flames when it hits the coals. Another reason to put the butter on at the very end. Off they come onto the tray that we smeared with more garlic butter. We'll let those rest while we dump on the whole bucket of zucchini. Those nice big pieces are so easy to handle on the grill. I'll just arrange them so they're cut side down and perpendicular to the grill grates. The cut sides brown better than the skin. Man, those are pretty. After they've been on for 2 or 3 minutes and they've gotten nice grill marks, I just slosh them around to give the skin side some cooking time, but not much. When they're just kind of floppy like that, they're not done, but they will be done by the time you pull them off, cut them up, and eat them. I want to make sure that they're crunchy and not slimy. Off they come to the other side of the tray where they will mingle with the meat juices and the melted garlic butter. Yum. We're done. Back inside. Now, people could just grab a steak and a few zucchini pieces and cut them up on their own plates. I like to pre-slice everything. Here is my surprisingly controversial method for carving ribeye. I just peel that delicious cap muscle off the not quite as delicious eye muscle, and that allows me to shave off the big bits of unrendered fat that live between them. I love fat, but I love melty or crispy fat. Not a big fan of big blubber hunks, and I'm hardly alone in that. With those bits out, I can just chop it all up into bite-sized chunks. Same deal with the fillets. Depending on where they were cut from, tenderloin steaks can actually have a lot of gristle running through them. Lauren doesn't like that, so pre-cutting the meat allows me to get in there and trim out all of the stuff that she won't eat anyway. Pieces all go back on the tray along with any of the precious board juices. Then the zucchinis. If they're all lined up like that, it's really easy to just hack them into bite-sized bits. Back onto the tray, and I turn on the burners under the tray to their lowest settings. That'll keep all of this food warm indefinitely, which makes this meal really great for like a little buffet situation if you have friends over. Now I'll just toss all the pieces in their own juices and the melted garlic butter. Each piece is just soaked in summery, smoky, buttery, garlicky deliciousness. Out onto the plate it comes. I would squeeze a little bit of lemon over all of that. And no, it does not look fancy all chopped up like that. If that matters to you, then, you know, don't do it. But in this form, you can just take a plate and a fork out onto the front porch. You can stand around and maybe light some more things on fire while you eat. Happy Independence Day to my American viewers, and to my British viewers, I say courgette.